The Electoral College voted on Monday. Joe Biden is officially now president-elect. After the Electoral College voted, Joe Biden gave a victory speech where, for the first time publicly, nationally, he called out Donald Trump's divisiveness and the fact that he insists that the election was stolen. This was good. We needed Joe Biden to do that to finally address it as a nation. Other than that, by the way, I was actually very concerned with how Joe Biden looked during that address. He did not look good. He did not look well. I'll put it that way. But that's a story for a different day. Here's the thing. After that speech, which was Monday afternoon, Monday evening, Kayleigh McEnany, Donald Trump's press secretary, apparently watched it and sat there stewing on it for a little over 12 hours before she finally got up, either got up the courage or I don't know, but Tuesday morning was just so pissed off about what Joe Biden had said 12 hours earlier, she finally got on Twitter and accused him of being the divisive one. Yeah, Joe Biden, the dude who's been like totally silent pretty much since the election. Nobody's really heard from him. He's not doing a whole hell of a lot other than appointing people and having meetings. You know, the things he should be doing. Kayleigh McEnany says, you're being divisive. By saying we're divisive, you're actually divisive. Yeah, how do you like that thrown back at you? Oh, you think we're divisive? Guess what? You are. Oh, I know you are, but what am I, Joe? Here's what she said on Twitter. 3-year fake Russia investigation, baseless impeachment, rigging election with mass mail-in voting with no safeguards, assault on democracy. No, let's forget for a minute that none of these are actually complete thoughts. I don't think anybody looks at Kayleigh McEnany expecting a complete, you know, thought out sentence. But nevertheless, nothing she is saying is true. Sure, there was an investigation, the Russia investigation, that essentially went nowhere. Well, it still made more money than it cost us. So, hey, that's a net good, right? Government made some money off that. It didn't hinder Donald Trump's ability to do anything, though. It may have pissed him off. It may have annoyed him. But it didn't prevent him from constantly going golfing, from going on vacations, from going on overseas trips as a representative of the United States. He still did all these things. He signed executive orders. He signed pieces of legislation into law. He did things. So what's your point, Kayleigh? And then, of course, you have rigging the election with mass mail-in voting. Rigging an election by having people vote. Really? That's the hill you want to die on, idiot? Folks, these people are grifters. Kayleigh McEnany is a grifter to the end, and honestly, she's one of the worst ones at it. Like, if you're going to be a grifter, you got to be good at it. Trump's good at it. Charlie Kirk is good at it. Kayleigh McEnany, you're just not. You're really not. You're going to struggle greatly once you leave this administration. I know you haven't been there for a long time, but you're just not very good at what you do. Maybe it's because the public was already tired and just decided to call you out constantly on your bullcrap, but you've been the worst. The other ones could take it a little bit. Kayleigh McEnany can't, and she rightfully got dragged all over social media for these asinine claims that she made. Donald Trump has, in fact, been divisive. And though I am no huge fan of Joe Biden, he has not been divisive. Hell, the only people he's divisive with are those of us on the left. Like, he's trying to shut us out. Meanwhile, embracing everybody on the other side. So when it comes to Republicans, no. Don't you dare say Joe Biden is divisive. If anything, he is far too welcoming of people like Kayleigh McEnany.